An evolving customer deserves an evolving business, one that can move with them, understanding their wants, anticipating their needs. Only a living business can achieve this. Become one today.
Technologists, what I have seen over the years is that technology and AI and IoT and all of these have seen adoption in several other domains so far in the last maybe 10 to 15 to 20 years, right? Customer care or smart cities, transportation or education, obviously, your knowledge. Only recently, over the last probably, if I'm not wrong, about 5 years or so, is where we're seeing more and more adoption and welcoming implementations in hospitals and diagnostic centers where the systems are primarily driven by technology. And in the last couple of years, more so with techniques like artificial intelligence as such, right? So what does it mean to this whole industry? From my perspective, I think especially artificial intelligence can help in two main parts. Given that we have a huge gap in healthcare delivery systems in two ways. One is the infrastructure as to how to actually deliver affordable and high quality healthcare in our rural and tier 2, tier 3 cities. That is one question. The second question is the difference and the huge ratio that exists between the demand versus supply, the number of expert doctors that exist versus the huge population that needs this, right? For both of these, I think AI is one wonderful solution.
Excited about artificial intelligence and other things, and there is significant explosion of knowledge in that. We have lots of permutations and combinations when we want to diagnose a case and when we put our findings together. But actually what happens that we have this thing in our hand, and whether we use it is 10% or 20% or 30%, how much we can master the technology and use it judiciously to the patient diagnosis and benefit, that would remain in the hands of operator. So basically what happens that currently whatever technology we have, it is like getting a technical assistant rather than an administrative assistant. So I don't have to Google it every minute, I don't have to read the books, but at the back of my mind, if my mind does not know, my eyes do not see. So you have to be knowledgeable even to use artificial intelligence, because when you have too many permutations and combinations, so people will have to get trained. And as sir mentioned about litigations and other things like Western world, so that also is an issue, because we want the Western treatment at Indian charges. So that also how the model can be accepted with the help of government and corporate sector all together to benefit the people at large.
For any solution to be relevant, it has to be a very, very user-focused solution. So if we think about developing AI solution in isolation without taking the user into consideration, I'm not sure things will go that far. So the first thing is we have to focus on the problems that the health system faces today and then try solving those problems. So we already heard from Dr. Bagai in the morning how inefficient the Indian healthcare system is, how profitabilities are going down, how doctors are bogged down by overwork. So across the spectrum, AI solutions can help. They can help improve efficiency in systems. You can have AI-based OT scheduling, OPD scheduling, wherein which will help you more efficient utilization of resources, which to some extent can help solve the profitability issue in hospitals, which most of the hospitals are facing today. Coming to the clinicians, we all know in a common hospital, a doctor is able to give hardly 2 minutes to a patient, and there's a lot of cognitive load on a doctor when he has to see a patient in an ICU or a patient in a case of infection or any malignancy. There's so many permutations, combinations that he has to make in his mind, so many things that go into depth decision making. So if that cognitive load can somehow be shifted to an AI-based engine, wherein you have clinical decision support systems, wherein you have screening systems like Nidama is working on, we are working in the infection control space on similar AI-based decision support system, it can really help the doctors to be more efficient. We cannot overnight increase the number of doctors, but we can make the existing clinicians more efficient using these AI solutions.
For more updates from CXOTV, please like and subscribe to our channel.